Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome to another Excel VBA tutorial. My name is Jay. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to use VBA to write a function to validate IP addresses. So here I have a table, and in column A, I have a list of IP addresses. Some of the IP addresses are valid, and some of them are invalid. So for example, for the first IP address, we know it's going to be invalid because for each group, the group value must be between 1 to 255. And since the last group value is 0, we know the expected output is going to be false. And for the second IP address, since each group value is between 1 to 255, so we know the expected output is going to be 2. And there are a couple more addresses that I'm going to use to test my function. But in column C, that's basically my expected result based on these IP addresses. The first thing we want to do is we want to go to the developer tab and open the VBA window by clicking the Visual Basic icon. And I'm going to start by inserting a new module. And let me make the window a little bit smaller. So I'll put the window side by side. Inside my module, I'm going to create a public function. And I'll name this function valid IP address. And we're going to have a single parameter, and I'll name this parameter IP address. And it's going to be a string data type. And the output data type is going to be Boolean. And it'll start have a typo, should be 2Ds. And I'll start by creating my variables. So I want to create an IP address variable, which is going to store my argument value. And next, we're going to create an array string data type variable. And since we know for each IP address, you're going to have 4 different groups of values. So here we can create another array string variable. And we're going to set the array size to 4. So remember, the array base is always starting from 0. So when you assign 3, that means this variable array's size is going to be 4. And I'm also going to create a helper variable. And I'll declare the variable data type as long. So here I'm going to insert air handler. So I'm going to say that on air, go to air handler. So here let me create my air handler stop. So basically every time when we encounter an air, we know the IP address is going to be invalid. We can set the IP address function output to false. And we're going to set the default output to 2. So we're saying that by default, wherever the IP address argument value is always going to be valid IP address until we hit any sort of error. So here I'm going to set the function output to 2. Now I'm going to set the IP address variable value with the IP address arguments. Oops. Now I'm going to split the IP address value and based on comma delimiter. So here, actually, I want to use the split function. And my expression is going to be my value, so it's going to be coming from IP address variable. And my delimiter is going to be period, not comma, period. Comma, period. Oh, period, yeah. So my delimiter value is going to be period. And using the split function, I'm actually splitting the value into 4 different groups based on this comma value in between. And here I'm going to check the upper bounds of my array IP's value. So uBounds, and I'll pass the array IP's variable. So we're saying that if the array size is not equals to 3, they want to go to air handler. And if I feel like I have a typo somewhere. So this should be Pearl. So here let me let me fix the variable name. It should be array IPs. Okay. So let's test it out. Here I'm going to print the value of my array IPs variable. So from the lower bound to the upper bound. So we can use the lbounds function. It will pass the array IPs variable. And this will return the lowest array base value. And so here we need to write a loop actually. So for I, it goes to lower bound to upper bound array IPs. And I want to print the value of array IP variable giving the index position. So here I already put a stop. Now if I insert my function, and I'm getting a false. So let's take a look at so this value didn't make the first validation, which is this check right here. So here I'll make a note. So first validation. Now I know the second IP address is going to pass the first validation. So here let me insert my function. And it's going to stop right here. Now let me open my immediate window. Now if I just iterate each loop, and it's going to print each group value. So 255, 255, and 255. Now we have the values of each group. So we can validate each value one by one. So here I'll assign the value to my IP variable. So here I'll assign the index is equals to array IPs, and I'll pass the index value. Now we have the group value, so we can do our validation. If one is greater than my IP address value, or if my IP address value is greater than 255, then we know the validation failed. So we want to go to our air handler. Otherwise, since all the validations pass, then we're going to set the function output to 2. And that's it. So here I'll make a note. So second validation. Now let's go ahead and test our function. So here let me remove this function right here. I'll start from scratch. So here I'll insert my function name, valid IP address. And I'll select my cell reference, A2. And I'm going to autofill this formula. So here, looking at the results, and we can see that all the outputs return correctly. And one of the benefits to write your own function to do any type of validation is that you can take that function and use that applied to your conditional formatting. So here in column D, I want to apply the function we just wrote and use that to our conditional formatting feature. Here I'll select manage rows, and I'm going to create a new row. And I'm going to select use a formula to determine which cell to format. And I'm going to insert my function first, valid IP address. And it's going to start from cell D2. And we know since our output is going to be 2 if the IP address is valid, so we want the inverse value of that. So here let me go back. So I'll insert the not function to reverse the value. If the value output is 2, then we're going to convert that to false. And I also want to make sure that my cell is not empty. So if a cell is empty, then I want to ignore the cell. So here I can also use the end function to add additional criteria. So here I'll insert my cell reference D2. It's not equals to blank. If these two criteria both return to 2, Then I want to format my cell background. I'm going to apply my cell background to, let's do this on orange color. So reddish orange. So with this conditional formatting, every time when I enter invalid IP address, then the conditional formatting will fire and it's going to apply the reddish orange color. So here, let's give it a try. So we know 123456 and 0 is going to be invalid IP address. Therefore, when I enter the IP address, it's going to apply the conditional formatting telling me that this value right here is invalid IP address. Now if I enter valid IP address, so 255, 255, 255, and let's use a different number, so 54. And because this IP address passed the test, so it's not going to format the background. And we'll do the same for the other, maybe just two more. So this one passed the test. And if I insert invalid IP address, and this one should, let me see, so I didn't highlight all the cells that I want to apply conditional formatting. So here, let me fix that. So I want to apply it from D2 all the way to D9. And click on apply. Now this cell is highlighted and told me that this IP address is invalid. So this is everything I'm going to share in this video. And hopefully you guys found the video useful. And as always, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys on the next video.